All right, working on a Whirlpool-built Kenmore side-by-side refrigerator today. And the complaint is the customer was using the refrigerator and smelled a burning smell, and the refrigerator started warming up. I opened the compressor compartment back here. I'm in the back of the refrigerator. Removed that panel, and I felt that the compressor wasn't running. I looked at the start relay. You can see it there. There is a black spot right there where it's actually burned through, and that was the source of the smell. Let's see if we can get a little better look at that. Whew! That sucker just burnt right up. It still smells a little bit. And so what we're going to be doing is replacing this start relay overload combination kit with a new one. I use only factory certified parts, genuine parts, no Chinese knockoffs for the guru. All right, I'm gonna get that installed and then we'll have another look at it. Okay, so these kits come with instructions and they're pretty foolproof. You just have to read them and pay attention to little details. In particular, you need to pay attention to when they're calling out what type of compressor you have. You can find that right on the compressor itself. In this case, we're dealing with the 90 HLP. And so, because the difference here is in which one of these relay overload devices goes in to this unit. And you just step right through the instructions, because in one case you'll use one of these, in other cases you'll use the discrete relay and overload. That all of this comes as part of the same kit. All right, one point of technique here. When the compressor start relay has burned up as badly as this one did, you have to check out the studs on the compressor. And that's these three prongs that stick out here, and that's what they poke, that's what it goes into. Sometimes I've seen them where these things just get burned down and melted down. In that case, it's game over. In this case, they've got some oxidation. You see it coming off of my fingers. I'm going to take some emery cloth, and some of it's a little sticky, and I'm just going to clean those off. You want to make sure you're getting good contact in here, because you don't want to create any resistance in here. If you do, you're going to burn up that relay again. This start device, the new one, will get burned up because you're going to create a high resistance contact in there. All right, there's the new start device, all plugged in, clipped in, nice and shiny and purdy. This is the run capacitor, and it just plugs right in there. And this is the wire harness for it. It clips in there. And so now we're going to plug in the refrigerator. Moment of truth time. And there we go. Compressor is running. You can feel it. I did a current draw on it, and it's well under 2 amps. I'm happy with that. And it fired right up, so we are good to go.